This video shows you how to execute the Phantom Power Mod on a BSS AR133. This mod is also mentioned in the manual of this DI box, but I haven't found any tutorial on how to do it, so here we are. This mod can be done in two ways. The first one resulting in that the power switch of the BSS AR doesn't affect the phantom power input anymore. This means that regardless of the power switch turned on or off, phantom power will activate the DI box. This is especially good for live use as you have one thing less to consider when plugging everything in. I mean, how annoying would it be if something like a bottle or a cable would turn off the DI box mid-set and now you're standing in front of an audience full of adrenaline and don't know why you all of a sudden have no sound anymore. The second way of modding the BSS AR would be to have the power switch shorted out of the whole circuit. This would result that the DI box is always turned on, which also means if you have a battery plugged in, the box will drain its power constantly. This way can be handy if you play in venues or into systems that don't have any phantom power available for your channel. But in a real scenario, this is basically never the case. Except you want to play straight into a TV or the mainboard of your computer. I highly suggest going with the first way of modding, but I will also show you later on how to theoretically perform the second method. Oh, and a small disclaimer, this is how I understand and did the mod from reading the PCB plan. It works for me like intended, but I don't guarantee for this to work 100%. So be aware that you perform at your own risk. Be really sure that you want to perform this mod, as you can also send your device into a specialist from BSS as stated in the manual. So now that we've covered what this mod does to your BSS AR133, let's look at what you need to perform this mod yourself. You will need a normal to big size screwdriver, as well as a smaller one, as we are dealing with two screw sizes. Up next, a soldering iron with its fitting stand as well as solder. Then you will need a sharp knife or even better, a box cutter. And last, this is optional, but if you want to be sure that everything works correct, is a multimeter or something else to check the connection we will solder together and break. Now let's start with doing this mod. First we have to unscrew 6 screws in total to open the DI box. Make sure to use the bigger screwdriver, as it's way easier to unscrew them with that one and not ruining the screws. There are 2 more screws located at the output XLR. These are smaller screws, so change the screwdriver. Now, lay the plate to the side and pull the PCB board out of the metal enclosure. There are 2 links at the PCB right here next to the battery connections. You have to solder link 1 together like I did here. Leave link 2 untouched. Turn the PCB around and you will see a connection path from link 1 to link 2. If you want to do the first possibility of the mod, just to disconnect phantom power from the on-off switch, you want to cut this lane with a knife, like I did. But please be more careful while cutting than I was. If you want to do the mod alternative, essentially bypassing the power on switch fully, you instead have to just solder link 2 as well. This mod is now done, and you should get signal when connecting to a mixer input, which has phantom power enabled. To ensure that all connections are as they should be, we can use a multimeter in a ground setting and touch both points of connection. On the back side, where we cut the connection, make sure to touch both connection point endings. On the front side, just the 2 linking points here. As you could hear now, my device outputs a tone, meaning there is a connection. Now we just want to put everything back together. Now everything is done and the BSS AR should run fine and be always turned on when receiving phantom power. Oh, and this also works with 18V phantom power as well. Thank you so much for watching and I really hope you've learned something new from this video and can now use your BSS AR133 with more ease. If you want more audio tips, please consider subscribing. And until next time, bye!